Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to our Southeast Asian zoo build. And we are not going to bring in a Southeast Asian animal, at least not one from the pack. Today we're going to do the final habitat for our river ride kind of thingamajiggy, and it's going to be a gharial habitat. Now it will have some similarities with the clouded leopard habitat, and that is, it's kind of a big cave thing with a hole in the sky. But I had this idea right back before I even started building this zoo, and I really wanted to bring it to life. So the inspiration, I guess, for the idea was to be on a river ride, on a boat tour, and to go past a sort of gharial cave kind of thing, with kind of like a blue hole in the ceiling, you know, with that light pouring in and all that kind of jazz. And maybe it's like an underground ruin or something like that, because there has to be something in there. And then, but the water behind the glass of the gharial habitat would be below the water of your river tour, if that makes sense. You'll see what I mean when we get there. All I'm doing here is building up some of the cave around our tour pathway thingamajiggy. Make sure that's all hunky-dory. I keep trying to like stagger more dirt on top of it to try to make it a little bit darker, but it doesn't really seem to want to. There seems to be a... I don't know what affects the lighting in the game, basically. It's not just the amount of material. There is something else that does it. Like, that main cavernous room there is really dark, but I can't get this bit to look as dark. It's very strange. So the point is, you're going to go along here, and then on the right-hand side, you'll see I'm starting to reduce the right-hand side, like how high up it is, because the water is going to start down there. So the water in the gharial habitat, at the bottom of the gharial habitat, will be lower than the top of the water on the boat tour. I just thought that was a cool idea. It's not something I've ever done before. We've done underwater tunnels before, you know, with like, say, the crocodile habitat back in our aquatic zoo. And that's definitely something you can do with the boat tour as well, but this is a little bit different. Because usually I think in a boat tour like that, you would have the land above the water, and this one is obviously below. It's just an idea I had and I wanted to do it, and I also wanted to do some big shiny lights. It's the last thing we're doing in our cave. After this, we're going to move on to the land and the binturong habitat, which I've got a really nice idea for as well, so we'll be moving on to that sometime next week. Anywho, yes, just doing a little test here, putting the water in, making sure it goes in, and then we're going to build the exhibit nice and small. I'm going to try to do slightly smaller exhibits than I usually do. It lets you put more detail in a smaller area and kind of hone in and focus a little bit more, I think. It depends on the animal and stuff like that, but for the gharials, definitely didn't want it to be too big. Don't know what I'm doing there, probably changing my music. Going to do a small test about how this works. I did end up putting too much cave on top and having deleted it just like last time, but that's fine, not a big deal. There we go, get rid of all that, it's going to work fine. So this time I decided to be very intelligent and build the habitat. Oh, I actually made these rocks and never used them. And build the habitat from the very get-go before we add in all the detail at the side. And really in my head initially it was just going to be ruins of some description and then earth kind of careening in from the sides. I wanted to have a slightly... I've just realised I completely forgot to do something I meant to do. We'll do it afterwards. I wanted to have a slightly alien... esque look to it, you know, not the film, but just a little bit fantastical, not necessarily realistic. I've decided, weirdly enough, I don't push the boat out enough when it comes to weirdness. I build predominantly strange habitats, but then I always stop a little bit short of just going full on bizarre, and I don't really know why. So I've been thinking about that lately. We might be changing it up a little bit, but I just wanted to have a sort of an alien planet-esque landscape, and then we're gonna... I sort of came up with some other ideas as we went along. I think it ends up looking pretty cool. It looks very dramatic, I'll say that much. It's super dramatic. And I did have something else I wanted to do and completely forgot about, so we get to do that afterwards. So yeah, just putting all the side of the landscape in. That's a little water test there. You can see how we filled in the glass tank with water and had the water at the side all filled at the same time. So my first idea, sort of new idea, was to have a trench, basically like a deeper trench in the middle of the habitat. And that's what that's going to be. Nothing down there in particular or anything like that, just felt like having a trench, basically. Now we're going to place about 5,000 rocks. It's an underground, underwater cave. There's got to be rocks. I did once again spend a lot of time trying to make the rocks feel natural and realistic and... you know, thematically appropriate, and kind of had this vibe going on where the rocks themselves were kind of like an infection. I don't know why it kind of came to that, but it did. Where they've kind of covered and spread around this underground landscape. And then eventually, we're going to build some ruins. Now, I was going to build them right here at the front. That was always the plan. But after putting the crevasse in, after putting the trench in, I didn't want to cover that up. I didn't want to block that from your sight line. So what I'm going to do is move these. I don't know why I did a little voice there. I'm going to move this ruin to the back in a sec. Well, I'm going to delete it and then do the ruin later. Wait for it. Oh yeah, so we're going to have the ruins at the back, and then half of the ruins are going to be crumbled off. The idea being the earth has kind of opened up. Oh, we should put a fire down. Oh, new idea, I need to write that down. Fire in pit. Fire in pit. So many ideas. So the idea, I'll talk about that in a second, as all I'm doing here is staggering rocks together. Fun though, it's fun to do. So the idea is that half the ruins, like, so the earth kind of opened up in this region. Maybe this used to be, maybe this is like an underwater city like Atlantis. Maybe it used to be ruins above ground and then it tumbled into the ocean, which I guess is what happened to Atlantis actually. So, you know, that's the idea. It used to be above ground and then it flooded and fell down, whatever. And then it's sort of resting on this plain we have here. And then the earth cracked open once again. And from that crack, kind of like half the ruins kind of tumbled away. So half of them are falling down into the crevasse, and half of them are kind of still there and relatively well built. That's the idea. Now, the idea I just had, because I decided just a second that the trench is slightly Pacific Rim inspired, because, you know, it's a big ass trench. What if we had at the bottom of the trench, like some orange slash red slash yellow lights, like burning upwards, so it kind of looks like it's, you know, cracked into the very foundation of the earth and it's uncovering the trail of magma under there. I think that could be very cool. We might do that. Oh god, I'm gonna have to do so much work post video. I never do work post video. And that would be kind of the thing I'm on about, wherein I've got this lovely, nice, dramatic underwater ruin, but it's just lacking a little bit of weirdness. It's fine, and I accept that most of what I do is not really what other people do, and I quite like that. But why not just take it a little bit further? I say that, Rudy Van Kamel in particular, does a lot of weird, inventive stuff, and he's a fantastic YouTuber to watch for Planet Zoo stuff if you're into that kind of thing. What was I going to say? Oh yeah, so the other idea, I wanted some jellyfish. I don't know why I didn't bring the jellyfish in, I was kind of meant to. I actually just completely forgot, if I'm totally honest with you. You can make jellyfish really easily with like a half sphere and some little tendrils coming off them. So we're just going to build some little jellyfish as well. That's something we did a long time ago. Something people have done on Planet Zoo for a long time now. We'll build some little jellyfish and have those kind of swimming midway up through the habitat, just to give it a little bit of life, a little bit of je ne sais quoi. Anyway, starting to build the ruins. You can kind of see what I meant here, where this right-hand side has tumbled down into the trench as the earth has opened up. I just like that idea, that the earth play crack the earth. Play crack the sky, technically, but still. Anywho, never have any good ideas for these ruins at all. It's always just a flat thing with a thing that's less flat on top of it. But as long as it looks okay. It wasn't meant to be like the major focus, but I just wanted it to feel fairly logical in that, you know, where certain aspects are and where certain things have fallen off like that. You know, not everything would crumble down, but, you know, the things that have crumbled down, they're all there and present. I wanted it to feel like that. Maybe there was some stuff on the other side of the crevasse where we are here, but that's all fallen down at this point in time, just because, you know, it's a devastating sequence. Also, two things. You'll be very proud of me for A, really not bringing in much foliage whatsoever in this entire habitat. Very proud of myself. And all the foliage is aquatic, except like four pieces. And next habitat will technically have zero rocks, if I had to guess. I don't think there will be a single rock. So those of you annoyed with my prevalence of rocks, you just wait till next habitat, folks. Not a single one. At least if I stick to the idea I've already got. Anywho, building up the ruins, stacking rocks together, just trying to make it look moderately realistic. I wanted something in there. I really like the crocodile, but it's a crocodile, not a gharial at the end of the day, and there just isn't a good gharial sign. We got all these new statues because of the update, you know, which added them for challenge mode. I don't know how much work these statues are. I mean, I guess what they have to do is they go in and they grab a pose off a specific animal, and then they're just applying a texture to it. So I don't think it's that much work, but there are a lot of animals in the game. I would love... Also, I wanted to use the heads. I know they're South American, but, you know, whatever. We don't have a... like an Asian temple pack, unfortunately. It would have been amazing if we got one, but we don't. So I'm going to use the heads. I've never used the heads before. They look stupid, but that's fine. But it'd be nice if we get statues for every animal in the game, basically. Like, I know that's work, and I accept that. But it would be immensely helpful for just so many exhibit designs at this point in time, so... Anywho, this is the basic idea. That's like the basic layout right there. I'm going to stick a llama in, because why the hell not, basically. A few more rocks, of course. And I really wanted the rocks to be dark and kind of clash with the brightness of the ruins. Now, as it happens, the whole exhibit is super dark, and you're not really going to see those color differentiations anyway. But it helped me kind of place them as well and stuff like that. And I just enjoy this, like, messing around with the rocks. Like, I enjoy making little formations and then adding little details in afterwards and just kind of trying to think about what a natural rock formation would look like in this situation, you know? And I think you'll kind of get a feel for what I mean, especially this pillar that I've built here. It kind of feels like a virus kind of crawling up and taking over the land slowly. It gives me vibes off, Prototype? Maybe that's what I'm thinking of, if any of you played Prototype on like the Xbox 360. So we're bringing in some aquatic plants. We're going to use the eel grass. Going to make this quite dense down here. But there's only this little region here and a tiny bit on the other side that's going to have any foliage. None of it's going to be on the rocks. There's not going to be any trees or anything. I've kept it very, very low key. Which is shocking, I know. I'm as surprised as you are. But I wanted the lighting and the atmosphere to kind of speak for itself more than anything else, you know? So a few more different plant lives in there, all kind of centered around the rocks. You need some open space as well, bringing in some of these, what these called hydrillas, which are nice for a little bit of backdrop. Decided to thicken up the grass, question mark? I did bring a tree in, because you know how much I love a fig tree, a strangler fig tree, attaching itself to things. Fig trees attached to things make me very happy, but I decided to resist. I don't know when I decided to resist. I think I bring it back in and then... Yeah, it's there for now, but I will be getting rid of it because it doesn't quite fit. And there's a few things, like maybe the vines don't quite make sense. I got rid of these as well. No plants peeking out of the rocks. My favourite thing in the world to do, and I decided to resist for the purpose of this video. You should be honoured, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, God. So yeah, now time to build the outside of it. It was around this point, by the way. I had already thought about it a little bit and kind of given it some consideration. But it's around now that I thought to myself, huh, a staff section is necessary and is going to be a pain in the ass. So this dead area here, even though this is sped up like 700%, is me thinking and just thinking and thinking and trying to plan out how on earth I'm going to build a staff section. I had to do a little test to make sure that you can still fill water in if it was only three... If the fence didn't go all the way around, if you know what I mean. So we've got a fence there. And so you can see there's like a gap below the fence, but it's going to be covered by dirt. But that still works. So the water system can handle that and it's okay. So we're going to have like this really high above ground staff system. Putting that little roof there just so I know where the water level is so I can... easily check that it's still staying at the same level even as I reduce the earth nearby. Just a little thing you can do to make it a little bit easier on yourself so you don't have to remember the exact level the water was. Just put a little roof there so you know. And now to try to build the bloody thing. So we kind of needed to lower the roof a little bit because there just wasn't enough room after the staff section. I could have put the staff section a little higher in retrospect, but could have made life a little bit harder as well. And then it's just a case of trying to make it so that the staff section doesn't let loads of light in and doesn't sort of get in the way. There's the tree gone. And I still wanted a hole in the roof. The idea was to have a hole. Kind of making this feel like an underwater cave and then there's a gap to like a light shaft above it. I actually might put more dirt around the shaft. It's a strange sentence now that I think about it. Just to give it that feeling a little bit more. I just had like ideas in my head of swimming down, like, again, slightly horror film inspired, I'll admit, but you know, there's always some attractive teenagers go spelunking and they're diving around and they stumble upon these underwater ruins and the light is pouring in from the top and it's this blue, soft light, hazy light, lighting everything up and then they get eaten by a shark. That was kind of the idea. I'm a little annoyed I've done it here because there are sharks in the Planet Zoo mod community, which are really, really cool. And I kind of wish I'd done this for a shark habitat. Although, I might build a ship for that, now that I think about it. Anyway, it's time for some lighting. Oh god, it's so much fun. Best part of this game is the lighting. So we're going to use the big spotlights. Look at that! Even right there! Gorgeous! It's so moody and atmospheric, and it's just because the lights are brilliant. These big, big spotlights are really good for these just wide open shafts of light. And then we needed some slightly stronger ones so you could actually, you know, see. At least see a little bit about what's going on and actually be able to see the Gharials when they come in. Oh, I should mention why we're doing the Gharials. So they are from, you know, Asia anyway. They are from an appropriate location. Really, I'm doing it because I like to do an underwater animal every time, and they got the deep diving mechanic as part of the Southeast Asia pack, I believe, or at least fairly recently. They didn't have deep diving until relatively recently, so now the Gharials can deep dive. They are from Southeast Asia, or at least Eastern Asia, India, etc. I had the idea and I wanted to do it, basically. It's still thematically appropriate, which is what matters. Anyways. There we go, light all pouring in there. It does really have the vibe I wanted. More so than the, I was happy with the other exhibit we did, but this one definitely has the atmosphere I was looking for. Bring in a couple of the deep sea water thingamajiggies, put some materials up there so the Gharials could be happy. And yeah, we should have the Gharials swim right down here and then swim over to the fish feeder. I'm not totally convinced on this underground lava stream idea quite yet. It might distract from everything else, but I do like the idea. Oh, this was another thing I wanted to start doing. So we're just going to have a random ass wall of water, because that way you don't see the exhibit at all. And then you go through and you're like, it's blah. Kind of more like a theme park. Yeah, I always build theme parks rather than zoos. You know what it's like. So it's kind of that's the kind of vibe I wanted to go for. Go through, torches on both sides, you go through the water and then bam, you're at the other side and you're awoken and you see this massive dramatic exhibit. No realism, just vibes. It's back to life. I have to do the other things in the other exhibit, so it's nice to go back to my roots a little bit, you know? Anywho, bringing in the Gharials, just wanted to make sure they worked. Basically, stuff like this can be super finicky, just because of where I'm building the staff section, etc. You know, it's never easy peasy. Wanted to make sure they could get down to the bottom of the habitat, and as you can see right there, she went for a little swim, got down to the bottom. And that is probably about it. So, we will hop in game. We're going to try out the lighting. I might skip the jellyfish. I'm going to think about the jellyfish, but we're going to put more Gharials in. Actually, there's already 8. We're going to put a Gharial sign in, which I've since this video designed. And we're going to try the fiery lighting. I do like the idea. We'll see if it works. I'll see you in a sec. Okay, I'll just give you a quick little torch so you can see it in slow motion before we get started with everything else. So you go forward. Kind of just following this. I've tried to make this again like low to the ground and kind of spooky feeling vibes, you know. You go through. I love that you can't see anything through this waterfall. I think that's very cool. Again, very theme park-esque. And then you go through and you kind of get this glimpse and then you go around and there is our habitat. And you can see what I mean by the water. Like the water is down here, which I think is really interesting. I don't know, this idea of two waters touching each other like this, I just thought was really cool. And inside it looks even cooler. And there it is, folks. There's our Gharial habitat. Really happy with it. Yeah, I'm sure it looks terrible in daytime, but we'll check it out. It's okay, but no. it's designed for the night. And our Gharials kind of just swim along and... Yeah, I'm really happy with it, actually. I think that looks really good. But maybe it could do with a little bit of va-va-voom, so let's try to do just that. First things first, I'm not going to spend too long doing this because I'll do this on my own time, but I'll just show you what I made. The Gharials are a problem and you'll see why. So if we go into billboard and we want our 4-meter projection screw. This is huge. Is that really? You inside the mountain? Yeah. Anyway, I just want to show you the bloody thing. So if we go down here, SE Asia Gharial site. Oh my god, it's so bright. There you go. So you can see the problem with the Gharial is that the bloody snout pokes out, and I did try to cut it down here on this line rather than having it come over here, but it just looks stupid, so the gharial snout has to kind of go along the whole thing. Next up, lights. Check out gharials. How you doing, buddy? You know what? We can hit play. There's no reason not to. So if you head up here, by the way, you'll see here this is... They will spend a lot of time up here, I'm sure. But their food source, their only food source, I was very careful about that, is down here. So I'm hoping once the fish start to pop up around this area here, you'll start to see them more often. Let's give these lights a go. Quite excited about this idea. So I think we probably want our big spotlight. Now it's going to be super bright. Where is it? There you are. Stadium light. It's definitely... Oh my god, that's so bright. That's okay, we can fix that. So the idea... I mean, that looks pretty cool. Oh, I actually like that a lot. It's lighting them from underneath as well. But we need to make it darker. So let's go into our colours. We're going to grab... Yeah, I mean, look at that! So cool! Oh, yes. Very on board with this. Right, so instead of making them darker... Oh, I kind of don't want to ruin it at all, but it's ruining my blue light. I'm very conflicted right now. I really am. I'm just going to put a few in and see what happens. It's going to look terrible. But that's okay. It's just a temporary measure. It's going to follow along the pit. I mean... Does that look terrible? It does ruin my lovely blue lighting a little bit, but... Oh, I don't know. I kind of love it. I'll have to think about this. What I was going to do... Let's grab these again. Let's just try sinking it further into the ground. The problem is that it spreads out like that, right? It doesn't work as well. What if we try the other lights? I think I prefer it, you know. What if we make the trench even deeper? No. The problem is, right, with these lights. The stadium, the area lights, I should say. Not the area lights, the stadium lights. This light breaks through things. Like, it doesn't bounce off materials, it breaks through, as you can see. Right there, for example. Unlike the other lights. So that is actually kind of an issue. What if these are down here? Can you see that? It doesn't have to be super obvious. That might... Oh yeah, that's going to be better. That's going to be super good. Right, okay, this is it. This is the solution right here. So what we're going to do... We're going to make like a little trifecta here. I want like a red one. And... I want like a yellow one. And I want like an orange one. Don't know why I wouldn't just pick an orange instead of going like this, but whatever. Actually, maybe that would be a better idea. Okay, never mind. Well, let's see what that looks like first. See, I really like that coloration. It's nice, that little bit of variety, I think. Okay, let's stick with this. Let's try this out. Let's get rid of that. Okay, let's make these into a group. Open that up. We're just going to place these down, again, along our pit. You never see into the pit, so it doesn't matter what it looks like down here. No idea how that works. Yes! That is exactly what I want. Oh, that's super cool. Still got that. Still beautiful, dramatic up there. And then... It actually might be a little bit too dark, oddly enough. I'm going to grab another set. I kind of want to light up here a little bit, you know? Like there. And also these rocks, if I can. That might be too far. We'll see. I think that's good. Might just get rid of the yellow one. Oopsie daisy. The more red it is, the more yes! Okay, I need to maybe do a... Oh my god, so many... so many gharials. I mean, doesn't that look so good? That looks so cool. With the gharials swimming... Oh, so happy right now. This is one of the coolest things I've built, I think. Yes! Now, I want to do some detail work here, because it's highlighting this wall a lot, and it doesn't look particularly exciting. But other than that, I'm pretty happy with it. Now, next step. Let's try... I'm not convinced by the idea for the jellyfish, but we're going to give it a go anyway. I need like a half sphere. It's kind of fun doing this on video sometimes. I don't really often... How big are they? Right, that's what we want, the small one. I don't often build on video, so... It's kind of fun you guys get to see my design process. As much as you can call it that, yes. Okay. So, now, on its own, that doesn't particularly look like a jellyfish. Can I put a light in there? Will that work? You're too big. It's a little one. Okay, if I make this into, like, a purple, I just want to see if... Because jellyfish, okay, maybe they don't glow, but they have that kind of, you know, feel to them. What I really want is, like, a little glass thing, but I don't think that's going to happen. Yeah. I don't think there's any particular reason for the jellyfish to glow. I don't think the jellyfish is necessarily a good idea. But I'll show you what I would do. This is how people do it. Is it vines? Yeah. It's basically just this, to be honest. You kind of just... Okay, I don't know why that'd be weird, but... That's about it. That's about all people do. There you go, there's a jellyfish. Oh, that is kind of cool. Oh, I do quite like that. I gotta be honest. Okay, no, screw it. We're gonna do it. I think it looks pretty cool. We're gonna build a bunch of them. I'm not gonna go too hard on it, because I think that'll ruin the impact. Just merge that into a group. We're just gonna make a few of them. Changed my mind very quickly. I think maybe just three of them, and we're gonna keep them all the same color, which is not something I would usually do. But I do want them to feel like they're all the same species. Okay, we're gonna grab all of them and we're gonna rotate them over there. Okay, I didn't mean to do that. Now the problem with the rotation is it's gonna let you see the underbelly. And the underbelly is the less effective part. But maybe if they're like that. Move one of them down, maybe. Maybe we add one more. A little bit further away. And maybe we move you a little closer. Or further, as the case may be. Okay, we're going to go for five. I know it's a three. I don't know. I don't know. I'm undecided on the jellyfish, but I think all in all, I'm pretty happy with what we've done here. I think that's a great scene. It definitely looks like what I had in mind. Actually, to be fair, with the fire going on, it looks completely different, but not in a bad way. Not to like big myself up or anything. I just think it's worked out really well. I would like to find out why my feeders don't seem to be working. Where are they? I may never know. Call keeper. There's another one around here somewhere. Oh, sir. I can't get that one because of the grass. The feeders do tend to take some time to work, so... Wouldn't surprise me if they don't work for a little while, but... I mean... It's that clash between the orange and red and yellows, and that's a, you know, quite bright blue. That's really why I wanted to get across. Not sure on the jellies. Let's see it from the boat tour. So you would go along here. Chuka, chuka, chuka. That looks so good from here. Oh, look at that. It's funny because it doesn't look like there's water in there, basically, from this side, just because it's so transparent. I did do that on purpose. I do prefer it inside here, but no, it's pretty cool from here as well. Yeah, okay, right. Well, folks, we'll spend a little minute with our Gharials, but then we are basically done for today. I want to get... Oh, no. New idea. And there's the fish. What if we get some bubbles coming up from the pit? Alright, is that going to work? Wait. Don't align the surface. I hate aligning the surface. Okay, let me just see what that's going to look like. Put a couple in. I mean, that's what you'd expect, right? You know, it cracks open and it's really hot in under there. So... You know, the water basically, as it gets down to the sort of lava flow area, it boils, essentially. Just need to experiment with this a little bit. It's never allowed to come into the habitat and actually look inside. Yes! Exactly! Precisely! Super good. It's always nice when something comes together, and this is why I like building underwater. You couldn't build the same habitat above ground. Now, obviously, because it is inherently an underwater habitat. But I think that's part of the reason I just really enjoyed the aquatic pack so much. It's just there's something about building these underwater habitats. And the lighting and the sort of creativity you can do that I really enjoy. I think the jellyfish are growing on me as well. I think that as a scene is pretty awesome. Okay, thank you so much for joining me. I will see you lovely folks next time. We will be, unfortunately, heading back to the land. The boat tour is going to end. We're going to finally get out of the caves. And we're going to go say hello to our binturongs, which I am excited about as a big fan of the binturong. Well, now anyway. Thank you so much for joining me. If you did enjoy this video, please do throw me a like down below. Comment what you think. And if you're new to the channel, make sure you throw a subscribe as well. And hit that little bell icon when you do, or you won't be able to see the bloody videos, because YouTube is silly. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm just going to watch this Gharial hunt for a second. It's kind of, he's not having the easiest time of it, is he? How you doing, buddy? I will say, by the way, exhibits like this, impossible for thumbnails, because I have to take the Gharial, but it's got no light on it, so basically what I have to do is take the Gharial to another habitat instead, and then bring it over here. Anyways. But yeah, most of them are going to spend their time up there at the top. That's okay. We could add even more of them in, just so they spend more time down here. We'll see. Thank you for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye.